What's going on, all my YouTube buddies? I'm Jacob with another movie review for you guys. With the recent passing of well-acclaimed director Richard Donner, I have decided to honor this director's legacy by doing a director project on this incredible director. So in today's video, I'll be kicking off this director project with my review of his directing debut, the little-known and quite forgotten about 1961 film, X-15. X-15 tells a fictionalized account of the X-15 research rocket plane, the men who flew it, and the women who loved them. So X-15 was released in 1961, and this marked the directorial debut of the one and only Richard Donner, who later went on to direct incredible works of cinema such as The Omen, the original 1978 Superman, The Goonies, the Lethal Weapon franchise, and many others. This was the first movie that he directed. Definitely a long way to go before he became a great director, because this movie was not really that good. And I'm not going to try to be harsh on Richard Donner in this video, especially considering he just recently passed away, and a good chunk of the world is grieving about that. So I'm going to try to be as respectful as possible in this video. But to be honest, I didn't really find much enjoyment in Richard Donner's first movie. I don't think that's fully his fault, though, because the direction in this movie, if we're going by what he was trying to accomplish, is actually pretty good. There are a lot of great shots and cinematography within this movie, because the movie focuses on these missions within the X-15 rocket plane. And there are some actually stunning shots within this film, especially when it deals with the missions involving this plane, which at the time was considered very groundbreaking, as there hadn't been ingenuity like this before. This is in the early 1960s we're talking about. So there are some stunning shots within some of the planes and the aerial sequences. Now, the poster for this movie says they actually filmed in space. That is a little bit of an exaggeration, because when you're watching the movie and you see the shots of the X-15 plane in space, especially near the end, yeah, there is a lot of visual trickery there. It does not look good. It does not hold up in today's standards, and it kind of shoots itself in the foot there, but then again, this is a 1960s movie here. They didn't have the technology back then to create sequences like that like they do now. So I guess that can be forgiven, but it does not look good in today's standards. What doesn't help with this movie is the movie is painting itself like a documentary almost. Like, oh, this is how the Air Force created the X-15 rocket plane, and that they can fly into space, and it's a continued expansion of the space race. Yeah, that's pretty cool, and it sounds great on paper. I'm a sucker for stories like this with NASA and the Air Force and the space race. You even got Jimmy Stewart narrating this film. I love Jimmy Stewart, so this sounds like the potential for a great movie.
And now, the X-15 is ready, manned by a pilot who will make all the decisions for accurate control and flight and re-entry and recovery.
But I feel like there's two clashes within the storytelling. There's the documentary style filmmaking, which was more interesting, and then you got the fictional narrative with the fictional characters, the big name actors they got playing these soldiers, the biggest one being Charles Bronson, and then you get to see their personal lives, the marriages that they have, and the impacts that they have at home. And that aspect of the film bored the life out of me. Even though there's some good actors within this film, even Mary Tyler Moore is in this film, and apparently this was her film debut. She later went on, of course, and had a successful career of her own, starring in, especially in television, with shows like The Dick Van Dyke Show and later The Mary Tyler Moore Show. She's a fantastic actress. But I felt like a lot of the talent was wasted in this movie. These characters are boring, they're one note, they're forgettable, they're cardboard characters. I don't feel like I know anything about these characters. They're just there to serve the purpose of the movie. And even the actual storytelling, it just goes on and on and on. There's not really any real action in this movie. It's just, oh, we're just going to test a plane. That's pretty much it. So pretty much, think Top Gun without the quippy one-liners. Think Top Gun without the cheesy fun. Think Top Gun without the impressive action sequences. And Top Gun without the banger soundtrack. This is just a dull, unremarkable movie, which I'm sure 1960s audiences would have found some great enjoyment with this movie, but I just saw a boring mess. I was struggling to stay awake watching this movie. I even took a nap while watching this movie, and even when I woke up, I don't know how much of the movie I missed, but I woke up, and I felt like I did not miss a thing, because before I fell asleep, they're like, okay, we still gotta figure out how to get this rocket going. And then when I woke up, they're like, okay, we're almost there. We still gotta get that rocket going. It's still a work in progress. And I'm like, come on. Just build the story up already. Make the characters interesting. Or they should have gone the documentary route. Have the actual people who worked on this plane talk about what actually happened and have the real footage instead of the movie footage. That would have been more interesting than this, because the real people are more interesting in a lot of cases like this. So X-15, Richard Donner's first movie. I was not a fan, personally. It's Top Gun without the fun. I guess this movie might have inspired Top Gun, especially with its aerial sequences and its military setting. And obviously Top Gun is a more fun and enjoyable movie. X-15, I respect its aerial sequences, but that's the only big positive I can say about this movie. And the fact that it did give Richard Donner a career, and he later went on to make incredible works of art. May that guy rest in peace, and I'm excited to see the great films that Richard Donner has to offer, the films I've rewatched, the films I'll rewatch, and the films I'll experience for the first time. But sadly, X-15 was not the film that put Richard Donner on the map. But he still has a lot of ways to go, and I'm excited to see the director's growth. This movie as a whole just did not work for me personally. I didn't get into any of the characters, and the structure of this movie was off pretty bad. The movie didn't know whether it wanted to be a documentary or a fictionalized drama. And the two didn't balance at all, and it led to a very unfocused, forgettable, unremarkable, and ultimately boring snooze fest of a movie. So at the end of the day, I'm going to give X-15 a 1 out of 5 stars, and on the 100 point scale, it's getting a 16 out of 100. So that wraps up my review of X-15 as part of my Richard Donner director project, where I'll be reviewing the director's complete filmography from his directing debut all the way to his final film. I'm excited to dive into Richard Donner's filmography, and even though I didn't enjoy X-15, not that that was Richard Donner's fault per se, because I know how much of a great talent he was the more he got into making movies. I am excited to see the films that defined Richard Donner as a director, the movies that I'll revisit, like Superman and The Goonies and Lethal Weapon, to some of the movies that I have never seen before, like Maverick and Conspiracy Theory and Assassins, just to name a few. There's a lot of exciting reviews coming to the channel, and I'm excited to dive into Richard Donner's complete filmography for this director project. So if you're a fan of Richard Donner and want to see more videos like this, don't forget to click the subscribe button and notification bell so you can be notified of future Richard Donner reviews. My next Richard Donner review will be for a 1969 release called Salt and Pepper, starring Sammy Davis Jr. I'm sure that'll be an interesting film, and I'm interested in checking it out. So be on the lookout for that review coming to the channel very, very soon. But But if you've seen X-15, let me know down in the comments below, would you follow the film? Did you love it? Did you hate it? But whatever your thoughts are, please be civil and respectful of others. If this is your first video, besides movie reviews, I also do TV reviews, ranking videos, and other fun stuff along the way. I have some more videos planned for you soon. Hope y'all have an amazing day. God bless, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!